Hello guys, so we are back with a really another application of symmetry principle, but not in integration now. Actually, it's an integration, but it's in disguised form of covariance and correlation, okay? So let's try to explore this. So it's a problem from past year's ISI 2018, ISI, the PSA part, the objective part, problem number 22. So let's see what the problem says. The problem says that if we have x1, x2, x3, which are IID positive valued random variables, and you define by this, then the correlation between y1 plus y3 is this. Now, if you think that why it's asking about positive valued random variable, it's asking a positive valued random variable. Otherwise, this x1 plus x2 plus x3 can be zero, which makes IID to be undefined. So therefore, this is a small restriction to it. So you must explore all these properties before moving on to the problem, okay? It makes your insight to the problem much better. So let's move ahead. So how will you do this? That's a natural question. So people have this wrong sort of idea that observe that y1 and y3 sort of, this is common part, and x1 and x3 are sort of uncorrelated, they're independent, so their correlation may be zero, okay? But it's not, because both are functions of x1, x2, x3. So they're dependent among each other. And you will see that the correlation is not zero. So that's not a good intuition, okay? A good intuition is something else. The intuition relies on the calculation sometimes. So let's see the calculation, where the calculation proceeds. Let me share the whiteboard and let's move ahead. Okay, so problem asks this following. You have x1, you have x2, and you have x3, and you have made y1 to be x1 by x1 plus x2 plus x3, y2 to be x2 by x1 plus x2 plus x3, and y3 to be x3 by x1 plus x2 plus x3. Okay, so and what we have got that x1, x2, x3 are independent. So let's proceed. So we want to find correlation of y1 and y2. Y1 and Y3 say. Okay, so for that we need to find what? We need to find covariance of Y1 and Y3, and we need to find the variance of Y1 and the variance of Y3, okay? So our first part of will be dedicated to the variance part, and the second part will be dedicated to the covariance part. I mean, the next part of the time, I mean. So observe that this is where the idea of the symmetry and the independence comes in. So variance of, can you tell me, variance of x1 by x1 plus x2 plus x3 must be equal to, so observe that due to the symmetry, the variance must be due to symmetry of the expression. Variance of this must be equal to the, and since they're IID, must be equal to this one. Must be equal to this one, right? So what we get? We get the variance of y1 must be equal to variance of y2 must be equal to variance of y3. So how can we use this result to our intuition? Think about it. How can we use this to our intuition? Like the calculation part, I mean. How can we use this to find the variance of y1, y2, y3? So in the meantime, let's compute the covariance. Okay, it's so keep it to the back of your mind. So we need to calculate the variance and we need to calculate the covariance. Observe this now. So for calculating the covariance, you can understand like this. So let's calculate covariance of y1, y2. It's equal to covariance of y1, y3, right? You know this, right? Because they are like exchangeable. It's symmetry principle, right? It doesn't matter if you put x1 and x2 because they're IID, okay? So that's the idea. So now, covariance of y1. So observe this property. What is the property? y1 plus y2 plus y3 is equal to what? x1 plus x2 plus x3 by x1 plus x2 plus x3 equal to 1. It's observed. Let's find out covariance of y1 plus y2 plus y3. That's equal to covariance of y1 comma 1, which is 0, right? Covariance of y1, any constant comma any random variable is 0. Naturally, it's not varying. So therefore, it's you can use the linearity of covariance. Now it's equal to covariance of y1 comma y1 plus covariance of y1 comma y2 plus covariance of y1 comma y3. Observe, as you told, that this is same and this is say what we are trying to find, s. So what we have got, it's equal to variance of y1 plus twice of s we are going to find, and it's equal to 0 that we have found out right here. And here we haven't found out it, like what is going to be the next variance, how do you find the variance and how do you find the, so using this variance now we can find out s, right? So now the next part of the video is asking you to find out the variance of the corresponding aspect of the covariance. Okay, so let's try to find out the variance now. So observe that first of all, let's try to compute the covariance, that is the s covariance of y1 comma y3 is equal to minus of variance of y1 by 2. Now, is the variance really needed? Let's understand. Now, correlation of y1 comma y3 is what? Correlation of y1 comma y3 is covariance of y1 comma y3 by variance of y1 root over variance of y3. Now, variance of y1 and y3 are same, right? Is it really needed, the variance? No, because it's minus of variance of y1 by root over variance of y1, the root over variance of y3. Now, these three are same, right? Like variance of y1 is equal to variance of y3, and therefore the product is variance of y1. So it gets cancelled, and there's a half over here that comes from here. Therefore, we don't need to calculate this variance at all, but we need to observe this symmetry, just this symmetry. Okay. So what we have used here, so where we have used the IID part? IID part is used here and here. Because when they're IID, they can be exchanged, okay, among each other, and therefore that reduces the computation. And therefore we have got the correlation to be minus half. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you got the connection between symmetry principle and this correlation. This covariance is actually an expectation variance, all like integration under the hood. So therefore, I will link you to the another symmetry and integration video I made. Until then, stay tuned, stay blessed, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.